Morning, sir. பாடி பேசல சப்பட்டு சொல்லுங்க. Maybe call when you about to start. Good morning, sir.
Yes, very good morning. Sanjit.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Yes, very good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Please, son. And
please. Good morning, sir.
Voice.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning, viewer. Who is just watching this online at live. Please mute your mic.
Okay, sir.
Fine. Thank you. Every morning is a surprise, and every sunrise is a challenge, and each day is a gift of God. With this sentiment, in our mind. Let us invoke God's blessing on all of us through a prayer. In order to raise this function, start the function with this prayer, I would like to invite Mrs. Lakshmikala ma'am to do the prayer. Please, ma'am, please stand up for prayer.
Baki nilai ini mai bendum, nilai benailad bendum, nerungin purul kadi padagi, maradi buti bendum, kalumi padagi, kaili basamagad nilai bendum.
Please be seated. Thank you so much. Light is a symbol of brightness and prosperity. It removes the forces of darkness and gives us positivity. With a noble thought, let us start the function by lighting the lamp. I would like our principal sir to lit the lamp. Please, sir. May the divine power bless us all of us. Thank you, sir. Now I invite our principal sir. Before that, I would like to invite Madam Satyasili ma'am, the Atal lab in charge, to give the welcome note. Please, ma'am. Please, ma'am.
A very good morning to everyone present here. And those who are present in the online mode also, thank you very much for joining with us, everyone. And I wholeheartedly extend my warm welcome to our principal sir, Mr. R. Shanmugamanandan sir, National and Radhakrishnan Awardee, who is the most admirable principal of our student and staff. He recently won the most admirable principal award. Welcome, sir. And next, my heartfelt welcome goes to Mrs. Subratna ma'am, CBSE teacher, who is the backbone for our work here. And next, my sincere welcome goes to our mentor, Navin sir, assistant professor, Komalpur College of Technology, Coimbatore. And he is also now playing a role of regional mentor of change, which was awarded by Atal Innovation Mission in collaboration with Niti Aayog, New Delhi. His mutual support makes this event possible. Welcome you, sir. Education is about far more than what happened within the four walls of the classroom. And we are very fortunate to have such teachers who is always ready to make this event a grand one. Welcome you all, ma'am, present here, and those who are present in the virtual mode also. Today's young minds are the tomorrow's future. My heartfelt welcome goes to our students. I also welcome the students and staffs from other schools who are joined this event via online mode. And welcome you all again to this event. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I invite our principal sir to address the gathering as well as the viewers. Please, sir.
Please, sir.
Yeah, very pleasant and eventful morning to all of you who are here and who are all in the virtual world. I could see Dr. Navaneetha Krishnan welcome you. God bless you all. And you are the success of all our Atal Tinkering Lab. And also welcome our Atal in charge. And she also won the award of Teacher of Change. For the Atal Tinkering, give them a big applause for that. And our Navaneetha is also on the mentor of regional, am I right, sir? So all these are added, I mean, examples of the hard work and commitment and dedication. Above all, my sincere appreciation goes to all my beloved children. In spite of hectic schedule and problem of COVID-19, who all participated in the competition and given a very nice, valuable projects. Yesterday, I had a chance of along the jury member to select the best on different bases. What all the bases you have selected, I think the judges will tell you in the time. As a welcoming you all, see, this is the Atal Tinkering Lab, one of the gift to all our students of this era. It is a nice project. One and one only ideas to create the scientists and their own projects, and education should go with the meaningful life by doing something, not it is mere mark excellence. So that is the reason Government of India and other people are taking almost all care, and really I could see some of the children actively involving themselves and doing their project, which are all missed our school days. So once again, I welcome you all for this August gathering of such a wonderful, which is going on virtually. So I have no list of all the schools who have participated. I'm welcoming all the principals, teachers behind the project, parents behind that project, and the students who are all involved in the process for this today's function. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Now I invite Vallisriya, class 10, to give the importance of celebrating this auspicious day. Please, Vallisriya.
Good morning to Anganath present here. I am Vallisriya from 9th Jasmine, here to share a message from why we are celebrating Engineers Day. Former President Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam once said, some of the brightest minds in the country can be found on the last benches of the classroom. Engineers play a vital role in the development of the nation. Countries around the world celebrate Engineers Day to appreciate the contribution of engineers. We celebrate National Engineers Day on September 15, the birth anniversary of Sir Moksha Gundam Vishveshwaraya, who has been considered one of the finest engineers of the country. He implemented an intricate system of gates at Gadapasla Reservoir near Pune. These gates raised the storage level in the reserve was also installed at Tigra Dam and Krishnaraja Sagar Dam in Mysore, Karnataka. He was instrumental in developing a system to protect Visakhapatnam port from sea erosion. He was also instrumental in charting out the plans for road construction between Tirumala and Tirupati. In 1955, the government of India honored him with the highest civilian honor, Bharat Ratna, for his numerous projects. The foundation of Jayanagar was laid in 1959. Hard work performed in a disciplined manner will in most cases keep the worker fit and also prolong his life, said by Vishveshwaraiya. He and his coach were the role model and inspiration to today's engineers and engineering students. Perfection is achieved not when there is no more to add, but when there is nothing left to take away. This is one of the quotes from the mind of innovators. Once again, I take the pride in wish you all the thinkers a happy New Day. Thank you.
Thank you, Valishri. Now it's time for us to switch over to online mode. So I invite Mr. Sri Navaneetha Krishnan, Assistant Professor of Kumaraguru College of Engineering, to take over the mic. Please, sir. We are happy to invite you. And
yeah. Thank you so much, sir. Respected principal and the people on the dais, of the dais, and people who are on the virtual mode, a happy morning to you all, and I wish you all a happy Engineers Day. By profession, by maybe by passion, all of you are aspiring to be an engineer. Some of you are aspirational engineers who are on the call. So I wish you all a happy Engineers Day. So as you said, today India observes National Engineers Day on account of the birth anniversary of Sir M. Vishveshwaraiya. So to add a note on Vishveshwaraiya, he was awarded a Great Civilian Award, Bharat Ratna, by Government of India at that time. So I appreciate Kamalavadi Atal Tinkering Lab.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, great. So I appreciate Kamalavadi had sent this school to organize the Tinker Fest on this day of National Engineers Day. Thank you so much. And thanks so much for inviting me for this Atal Fest online virtual program. So as we all know, engineering and technology has made a great impact in all the verticals of, you know, the things whatever needed for day-to-day life, starting from the agriculture, healthcare, and the space, transportation, everything. So it is very difficult for us to find anything which doesn't involve the technology or engineering in it. So that sort of importance and that sort of significance the engineering has. So the role of engineers again is crucial and very important in making everything a possible one. So ultimately, I strongly believe, and I represent an organization, world's largest technical organization, called IEEE, where our motto is advancing technology for humanity. So we strongly believe the technology, the technological advancement, whatever it may be, if it is not serving the purpose of humanity, then there is no point in having that technology or advancing that technology. We ultimately believe that the technology should be serving the humanity, serving the people, to eradicate the poverty, and to make the people to live with happy, healthy, they should live in a harmony. So that sort of thing should happen when we are advancing the technology. Otherwise, there is no use in advancing the technology at all. So United Nations has came up with a great framework called United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, where it encompasses or focuses the need or the priority areas, whatever we need to consider by achieving, which will make the people to live in a happy and harmonious life. So as an engineers, we should, you know, always think about the serving the community aspect whenever we are dealing with any sort of project. Ultimately, we should be, you know, focusing on the outcome of whatever we are, whatever engineering project, whatever science project that we are doing. Also, I would like to, you know, talk to you a little bit about the various things like patenting and copywriting. So there were not only today, but even also olden day, there were many unsung heroes from India who were the great, who were supposed to be the great innovators and scientists in the world. For example, we all know Marconi invented the radio. That is what we learned through our books. There is also, you know, at present, there is also a big controversy going on that whether Marconi invented the radio or the Tesla invented the radio. That's a part. So again, the basic behind the Marconi's invention is from India. So I don't know whether you know this or not. So a person, a great technocrat and scientist and physician from Kolkata, now it is part of Bangladesh, called Jagdish Chandra Bose, who invented the communication, radio communication, before the Marconi. So, in fact, Marconi's work itself says that the basics, the building block that he derived from the Jagdish Chandra Bose work. And we have many such technocrats, and you can name like G.D. Naidu, who had a great contribution towards science and technology. They were like, you know, unsung heroes. They were not, you know, famed with any of such big awards or honors all over the world. But the reason behind that is they have not, you know, patented many of the things, many of their inventions beforehand. You know, after that, somebody who on the later stage, based on their invention, somebody has added something and they have patented it. That's the why, that is the reason they got, you know, they came to limelight, and their names and their contributions were you know, put up in the visibility area. So we also, as and when we invent something, we also need to record wherever it needs to be. Also, today there is another today is the birth anniversary of another great leader who is then former chief minister Sri C.N. Annadurai, who was also a great leader, who has made a great contributions to the growth of our own state, Tamil Nadu. So we also learn, you know, we also try to read about them. We also try to learn about them, because, you know, ultimately all the leaders, whoever has made a great impact, whoever we know, in fact, actually they have got, they are not like, they were not like the people who just reached that position in a day or in a month or in a week. So they worked a lot, they learned a lot, they had a very big, very good experience. They, you know, faced their failures. I would say they converted their own failures as a great experience for them, and they converted their failures as a stepping stone for their success. So this is the right time for us. We need to learn how to handle both the things. We need to handle the success as well as the failure in a great way. So, you know, ultimately the knowledge and wisdom, whatever we, you know, get out of learning and exposure will give us the strength and will give us the path and will give us the strength to handle the success as well as the failure. So I would like to quote Dr. APJ's thought here. So he says, you know, this is the reflection of his thought on the purpose of learning. So he says, learning gives creativity, and creativity leads to thinking. Thinking provides knowledge. Knowledge makes you a great. So we should not read, or we should not learn anything just for the sake of it. We should learn just to have a knowledge, we should ultimately, our objective, our aim is to have a knowledge, not by not getting the marks. So if we do so, we learn to, you know, get the creativity. So if our creativity makes us to, you know, think, so ultimately we should be a great thinker. And if our thinking provides a knowledge, definitely we will reach our great heights, and definitely we will be in a position to take whatever failure it may be. So I would strongly know, when comparing the students here, I'm quite, you know, older than you, not than your you know, teachers or and the dignitaries who are there. So out of my experience, I'm telling you, life won't leave you at any point of time where, you know, you will not definitely face a dead end. Definitely there will be always a hope. So we all, you know, somebody used to say, always there will be a hope. So where life definitely won't let you in a dead end. Definitely there will be a hope, and there will be a, you know, option to take up. That is your choice whether to take up. So I would strongly suggest, you know, think and try to take up the right things. So yes, of course, we need to, you know, Dr. Abdul Kalam also strongly believes and tells.
Okay,
and,
sir.
Yeah, yes, thank you so much. Yeah, he insists the students to think big and, you know, imagine or have aims in a big way. Like I would say, thinking or aiming for very, very, very small things is the biggest crime that we do. Always we need to aim for high. So if you definitely, so that if you want to become successful, or if you want to become whatever you want to be, your imagination should break the limitations. So you need not to limit yourself, like, no, this is my boundary, so I need to think only just to get a MBBS seat, or just to become a doctor. That is not the only goal. There are many things beyond getting the medical seat and becoming a doctor. So you are learning, ultimately our creativity, our thinking, our knowledge will have a wisdom to understand what is our purposes. So again, Dr. Abdul Kalam is, you know, suggests four rules, I would say, four mantras for a great success, which is have a great aim, as I told you, not a very small, very very small aim. They have a big aim, and continuously and constantly work and gain some knowledge on it. And definitely you need to put up your hard work in it. You need to have a perseverance. Finally, you will achieve the heights. So with this day, we pledge ourselves to learn, not just to get the marks, or not just to get the MBBS seat or BE seat, whatever we want. Our objective should be to gain a knowledge. See, if you do so, definitely you will not have any dead ends throughout your life. So with this, I would like to conclude my short today's speech. Thank you so much again, Kamalavathi management, principal and teachers, for inviting me and giving me this opportunity to talk with the young minds of tomorrow. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your wonderful speech and the experience that you have shared. Definitely, we will believe that this gives a hope for all the young innovators and scientists to keep your words, and they will just have the work on their success path. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Now I invite Syed Mohammed Buhari of Class 10 to give a talk about this celebration of Thinker 2020. Please, Buhari.
First of all, my good morning to all the students and teachers who are present here and virtually. And I'm Syed Mohammed Buhari. I'm here to give a speech about the Athletic Green Fest, which is being conducted this year. The Athletic Green Fest is an event connected to enhance and motivate the students and to explore out of box. The Athletic Green Fest is to motivate the students and make the students to explore out of the box. And we hardly motivate the students to become an entrepreneur. And this year, this event is conducted as virtually in Kangari Senior Secondary School. So over more than 40 students have participated here from various schools from various districts. So I read out the school names: Kongo Matriculation Higher Secondary School, Sri Vidyalaya Higher Secondary School, Sri Niketan Higher Secondary School, CRR Public School, Kanchi Sri Shankara Senior Secondary School, Kumaraswamy Kondu Higher Secondary School, Devangar Girls Higher Secondary School, Amitra Vidyalaya Higher Secondary School. I heartily congratulate all of the participants on behalf of our management and our school management. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Bohari. Now it's time to announce the results. So in order to read out the result, I would like to call upon our principal, sir, to announce the result. Please, sir.
Once again, pleasant morning. I'm standing before you with the honor of announcing the results of this project competitions. Before I let go into that, see, the participation itself is success. Whether you're winning or losing, it's not matter. Really, as a jury member, we all enjoyed all your projects, and really had a tough time to select the best. So it shows that you should win a medal and you should go and keep it in a showcase. It's not the purpose. It's a beginning for the process to involve yourself in the future scientists so that you can contribute for your nation, your family, and your school. That is the strongest motto to begin this. But even then, when there is a competition always tells the competency of the child. So that is the need of the hour. So every child has competed enough in different ways. But when the competition comes, there are certain rules and regulations. I think I was asked Mr. James to announce the rules and regulations in which we have selected all this. Then that will be better. Then I'll announce the results.
Good morning, Mullah Gandhi here. It's a really tough task to find who's the best in these participants. So, yesterday we had a meeting with our principal, sir. So, that time we analyzed things as the project should be innovative and should be eco-friendly. And the presentation also considered. And then the project which is need for our society. So, in this criteria we analyze and select this best three, and our principals are really concerned with this. We must select the correct persons without any bias. So we have, I hope we have done this job in great manner. So now I request our principals are to, it's a really tough task for me. So I appreciate all the students who participated in this event. Thank you.
I hope you all cleared the rules and regulations by which the jury has done his job. Now the awaiting results are ready. We go by the, since there are two second prizes, there is no third prize. Second prize for the project Safety Aeroplane by Anish Ankar of Kamalabadi Senior Secondary School. the one more second prize for the eco-friendly conductive paint by Arjati surroundings of Kanchi Sri Shankara Academic Matrix. So congrats to the Kanchi school nearby in our district. So I congratulate all the teachers and principal everyone who played in this section. Now come to the first case. Smart garbage collector by DP of Kongu Matriculation High Secondary School. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for announcing the result. We are so glad to have you, sir. And with the SAS wish, we are also giving consultation prize for 5 more students. And here the consultation prize goes. First is Smart Irrigation by Umbilan of Kongu Matriculation High Secondary School. And second one is Women Safety Tool by Madhumita. Third one is Incubator by Mohammed Umar. And fourth one is Security Door Alarm by Jay Vishwa of Kamalara Senior Secondary School. And fifth one is Sharmila for Women Safety Tool. Thank you so much, students. And here with, we are also like to appreciate the participants, and I'm going to read out the participants who have participated in this competition and hearty wishes for them too. And first one is Deepti, second is Mudilan, third Purva Praveen Nagar, fourth one is Chinnaswamy, fifth one Roshan Raj, sixth Gopika Shri, seventh Dudvishwa, 8th Kavinesh, 9th Monish, 10th Netra, 11th Prem Kumar, 12th Ratna Prasad, 13th Madhumita, 14th Sharmila, 15th Divya Lakshmi, 16th Sanjeev, 17th Netra, 18th Sailesh Kumar, 19th Kumar Guru. Thank you, participants. Thank you for a wonderful participants. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for announcing all the consolation prizes. Great people are great listeners. So through this, I would like to request all the participants who virtually communicate with us. So please mute your mic, so it will be easy for her to enjoy as well as to have a keen attention of the program. So it really is a great success. So in order to make it more successful, so I request all the participants in the upcoming programs to unmute your mic and just really enjoy the program. Now it's time for to put up the thanks. All well that ends well. So I would like to invite Mr. James to put up his vote of thanks. Please, sir.
Once again, good morning to all of you who are gathered here and individually. So it's my privilege to put up my vote of thanks. First, I would like to thank the schools that motivate their students to execute their innovations. The platform of TinkerPlus 2020 conducted by our school Kamalavati Senior Secondary Sagupuram. Then I would like to thank our school management for their encouragement and moral support. Then I thanks our respected principal, Sri Shanmugharandan, Dr. Radhakrishnan Awardee. Recently has received most admirable principal award for excellence and leadership in education. You have been a constant support and you have given a lot of encouragement. Thank you, sir. On behalf of the school management, principal and all the students, I would like to thank our chief guest, Sri Navaneetha Krishnan, Atal Regional Mentor, Assistant Professor, Kumaraguru College of Technology, for encouraging and motivating young scientists to reach the height of their every innovations. Thank you, sir. I thank our beloved administrators, Srimadi Subratna ma'am, for their support and motivation. Thank you, ma'am. I would like to extend my sincere thanks to our school technical team, in charge Mr. Ranjit, Mr. Liana Prabhu, Mr. Asik, and Mrs. Sri Priya. In this pandemic period, they made this occasion successful with their wholehearted support. Thank you, team. I thanks our coordinators and staff members for their enormous cooperation in organizing this utter fest. Even like this cannot happen overnight. The wheels start rolling weeks ago. I extend my sincere thanks to Atal in charge of Kamalavati Senior Secondary School, Mrs. Sail Masini, and the lab assistant, Mrs. Lavanya, who are working for this Atal Tinker Fest 2020, getting grand success. Thank you, ma'am. Last but not least, I thank you all the viewers who are actively watching this live celebration in Zoom and YouTube also. Thank you. Thank you once again. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. So it's time to wind up.
Thank you, ma'am.
Please, let us stand up for our national anthem. Please, ma'am.
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हिंद भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा कावेर उत्कल बंगा विंध हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जय गण मंगल जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे।